Hey, I know you use your computer to edit your photos, but let's consider an iPad too. Capture One has just released their iPad app. I'm gonna download it and compare it with Lightroom Mobile, Lightroom for iPad. Let's see how do they compare. Let's begin with Capture One. On the left-hand side, you can see the import section. I've already imported some RAW files from my iCloud drive, so let's see one of them. At first glance, we see the histogram on the top right corner. Also, gallery can be seen at the bottom. When we click Info, the I button, file properties can be seen. As a setting, we can switch the location of the tools, right or left, and turn on and off the histogram. Inside the settings, we can manage cloud storage settings and cellular data usage. Quick gestures can be seen as well. So, the first option on the left side is rating. You can give stars and colors, then filter them later. Second one is quick filters and presets like exposure mode, color masking, film grain presets, etc. Also, there are quick color styles like color filters. The third is rotation and cropping. On the right-hand side, you can see the rotation icon as well as rotation angle. Also, you can change the aspect ratio and crop. The keystone part shapes the perspective. It might be good for minor architectural tweaks. And here it is, the much-awaited color correction part as a fourth option. I must say, it is below my expectations. You'll see when I switch to Lightroom. Black and white mode is as it should be, nice and detailed. White balance is the same, Kelvin and tint. We need to get used to this dual hand interface though. Select the tool from the left side, adjust from the right. We can also choose one of the white balance presets, of course. Exposure is as usual, but the HDR part that gets me excited. I mostly use these, you know, the highlights, whites, shadows, blacks. When you hold your finger on the screen, it shows the original file, so you can do before, after, like this. The clarity and clarity modes are here, alright. The haze can remove some haziness, if there is some. Color part has the selective color thing. When you select a color, you can change its hue, saturation and lightness values. Okay, that's great, that's something we use. Also, you can add a little bit vignette, maybe. The last section has the sharpening and noise reduction options. Also, film grain, of course. Capture One users love to add film grain, including me. Also, there is a Moire option. I guess it removes Moire, because it's something we don't want. By the way, you can copy all the changes you made and paste into another photo, of course. Let's paste it here. That's it for Capture One. Apparently, it doesn't have any selective tools like masks. Let me show you what Lightroom has to offer now. Same photo, this time everything on the right side, because this is what Lightroom users are used to. There are presets again, same light sliders, white balance presets, But I love this hue slider more, because it shows which color I'm aiming for. More visual. Maybe Capture One can add that later on. Also, there's a color grading tab, which looks familiar from video editing softwares. Three wheels for shadow, midtones, and highlights. And the fourth one for overall look. Alright, good. So clarity, texture and dehaze is also here, vignette as well. Sharpening, noise reduction, same things. Nothing different. But here's one thing that Capture One doesn't have. Chromatic aberration remover and lens corrector. Rotating and cropping is a must. Yeah, but what's different in Lightroom then? Well, healing brush. Healing brush that we know from Photoshop. I'm just clicking randomly, but you get the point. You can fix things. It gives good results if you do it carefully. Lightroom can remove unwanted things. So let's look at another photo with people in it. This was a cover photo of my band. The next section in Lightroom is masking. We can select different objects or people and color them differently. Select subject and select sky works automatically. This is the linear gradient, for example. Subject mode selected us, for example. It detected people. But there's a little bit overflow, but we can add or subtract some parts manually via brush. Sky selection is also automatic and works fine, as you can see. So what do you think? Which one is better? You can get Capture One, just the mobile version, for $4.99 a month. But also Adobe has a photography plan, which is $9.99, but it includes PC version of Photoshop and Lightroom as well. Which one is better? Tell me your ideas about mobile editing and these apps. And until the next video, take care, bye.